Bricklaying is probably one of the only jobs out there that actually still requires a skill to do it. You can drive a digger, you can pull levers, but bricklaying, it generally takes how you spread your mortar, how you're placing your stone. Your majority of sites we turn up to, we have the rest of the subbies turn around and go, whoa, look what you guys are doing kind of thing. Look at the walls going up, the bricks going in. It's definitely a pride thing. It's not for everyone. Personally, I've been doing it about 10 years. I started up Nate Tyler Bricklaying about 5 years ago. We employed our first guy about 4 years ago now. So we've pretty much been slowly building our own team. We've had a couple contractors and tradesmen and give us a hand, and there's just different bricklayers from a different town lay different bricks to the next person, and that shows when you come to doing houses kind of thing. So it's not for the faint-hearted. It's probably the thing I got raised on a dairy farm. I like to think I was brought up around hard work, and this job here has been the biggest challenge I'll I think it's where I got my passion from, to be honest. Every day has been a challenge for me, whether it's right up to now. It's whether it's what you're lifting or what your body can physically do. We've got a good team of bricklayers. Everyone wants to come in and give it their best, and they all work hard and sweat whether I'm there or not, so it definitely makes my job a lot easier in that sense. One of our first tradesmen we employed, luckily he laid bricks just like myself, so we've kind of got along just well from the day dot. But from there on, we've employed fresh people and brought them into an apprenticeship. And at the moment, one of our apprentices is about 3.5, coming up 4 years in, so he's about to be signed off, and the next guy behind that is about 3 years. So we're all about a year apart between apprentices at the moment, so essentially starting a ladder. When I'd done my apprenticeship years ago, they pretty much told us at Tech if we had any mates that we could get into the trade, because bricklaying was one of the least amount of apprentices for that year. Out of every trade, bricklaying was the least amount. So I'd say it comes down to the lifting and all the hard mahi that goes behind it. But I think it's worked out for us in regards to business. We're coming through a time where a lot of, I guess the old dogs you'd call them, are on their way out, and we're on our way in kind of thing, and there's not a hell of a lot of younger teams to replace them with, so perfect for us.
I'll put the camera on up. You're the one here that you've got, huh?
It is a 4 year long apprenticeship, getting into it, which you'll probably find 4 years isn't long enough either. Starts at the bottom and makes their way up, but you could be earning upwards to $40 an hour by the time you get to a qualified tradesman running a team. Well, everything else included. One of our boys has a fuel card and a work ute that goes with it, and he's on a good pay wicket as well, so you can go anywhere really. Bricklaying's in every country of the world. Yeah, just obviously reputation at the moment. Just want to be the best out there really.
How do you do that?
Laying everything to the mill, being tidier than everyone else really. I'm always trying to sit there and think in my head, what can we do better than the next Joe Blogs up the road? Say everyone lays the exact same bricks, what's the next thing we can do that's having a tidy site as we go? Or, you know, the wastage on sites, the materials you're using, the off-cut pile, and every other little point we try to get at. Hard work definitely pays off in any trade you're in, really. Reliability, incentive, it's a trade where you've got to look for work. It's always in front of you. It's always there if you look for it, it's always there. It's more initiative really. Yeah, people that turn up every day is a big thing for me. Every one of our boys, since we've employed them, I think the latest someone's been is about 5 or 10 minutes, and that's pretty good in my eyes. I wouldn't tell them that, it's not good enough, but it's pretty proud for that. Everyone turns up every day and on time.
Yeah, life is literally about showing up, isn't it?
I was going to say, believe that or not, but our boys, yeah, literally within 5 or 10 minutes over the last few years, not even lying. Well, this is the end of the job.
You get that sense of pride, don't you, when you do a job and it's done right.
Done properly.
Yeah.
No, too right. Pretty bloody proud of what we do. Worth trying, mate.